This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. The ultimate goal for this course is to build a Django package, which we are going to host on the Python package index. Anyone will be able to download this package and install it into their Django application. We have already developed the basic functionality of our package in the previous section of this course, where we built an SQL query inspector middleware. So we now need to take our middleware, package this up so it can then be served from the Python package index. The Python package index, or PyPI.org. If you're not familiar with the Python package index, it is a repository of software for the Python programming language. It is considered the largest and, in many respects, the default software repository for Python developers to store and share Python software. We have already used this at the start of this course, where we install Django. Django is stored and distributed from the Python package index. We downloaded the Django framework utilizing pip, the Python package manager. So this is Django here that we installed earlier. You can see that we utilize this command, pip install Django, to actually install Django. So our goal is to take our middleware that we created in the previous section of this course, package it up, and then upload it and create a new instance here in the Python package index so others can download it. Before we start actually building our package, just take a look at some of the existing packages on the Python package index. It gives you a good idea of what type of information we're going to need to supply when we actually build our package. So here we have a product description. On the left-hand side here, you can see some navigation items and links to the homepage, maybe to the source on GitHub, etc. So we are going to need to supply all of this information in order for us to actually build our own package here on PyPI. So that does mean that you are going to need to register and sign up to the Python package index. But hold on a second before you do that. Let me just introduce the idea of the TestPyPI. Now, before we upload our package here to the Python package index, the main index here, there is a test facility where we can practice this process and view our package before we then commit and upload it to the Python package index. So if I just type in TestPyPI here, this would take us to a link to TestPyPI, the testing Python package index library, if you like, where we can, like I said, we can practice uploading and look to see what our package is going to look like if and when we install it or upload it to the main Python package index. So in actual fact, what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to register individually to the TestPyPI page and the actual Python package index. So go ahead, register here to the TestPyPI, so the test.pypi.org. And then in addition to that, you'll need to register also to the Python package index. As I have already mentioned, and as you have already seen in this course, we manage packages from the Python package index using pip, the default Python package manager. There are other managers that you can use. Pip is the default when you install Python onto your machine. We can get a little bit more familiarized as and when we start building our package and start to practice actually installing our package from the Python package index. The general process for building a Django or any Python package is that we need to first of all build the actual app that we want to distribute. And then secondly, we then need to package that app up in a way that can then be distributed over to the Python package index and then downloaded via pip or any other Python package manager. Once we've created our package, we then need to take the third step, which is then to upload the package to the TestPyPI or the main Python package index.